देशको शैक्षिक वातावरण, अध्ययन, अध्यापन, नीति निर्माण र शैक्षिक चेतना फैलाउने उद्देश्यले प्रसारित कार्यक्रम शैक्षिक छलफल। नमस्ते एन्ड गुड आफ्टरनुन, आई एम रविन बस्नेत एन्ड टेक्निकल्ली बिङ सपोर्टेड बाई सतिसा सुवाल इन रेडियो जनसन्स आर 107.9 मेगाहर्ज एट द प्रोग्राम नेम्ड एजुकेसनल डिस्कसन। एज यु नो द्याट दिस प्रोग्राम इज डेडिकेटेड टु यु स्टुडेन्ट, टिचर, प्यारेन्ट एन्ड द पिपुल हु आर डिरेक्टली इन्डिरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टु एजुकेसन। For more than 2 years, this program has been airing via this radio on Sunday 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. I have been discussing about Nepal's overall education and its present condition with intellectual and academic personalities. Besides this, we analyze and dissect the educational activities very closely and in micro way. In today's program, I have invited educational personality named Rajesh Sapkota. He is a working lecturer of Samriddhi College, Bhaktapur. Mr. Sapkota, you are heartily welcome in this program.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ravi, sir.
Now, I like to start some issues which is directly related to our society, especially in a sector of education and overall education. Okay, right? Now, Mr. Sapkota, in Nepal, our students, our citizens like to go abroad. And in your opinion, your experience, how do you feel about that?
Actually, thank you for your question, Ravinji. Actually, going abroad in itself is not bad, but actually, government of Nepal should think about those issues. There is a huge problem of brain drain during our time, and the intellectual personalities, they're moving abroad by getting PR or green card, but there is no proper management of intellectual citizens, good human resources. That is the problem of government, and the policymakers should think about those issues. Personally, those who are going to abroad for their further study, that is good. If they get back to Nepal for contributing their country, then that is better. I think there is nothing wrong for going abroad.
Going abroad and not coming to Nepal, how it will be?
Yeah, of course, that is a great loss, Ravinji. That is a great loss. Actually, an intellectual personality who is highly qualified and he is going to abroad by getting PR or green card. Other countries, especially Western and European countries, American countries, they're providing PR, green card, and certain luxuries, scholarships for those citizens of Nepal. But government of Nepal, it has not acknowledged their intellectuality, their personality, those cream manpowers, they are disappearing. That is the problem. If they do not get back to Nepal to serve their country, that's a big issue.
Mr. Sapkota, okay, I like to go abroad. Mm-hmm. And I go abroad. Mm-hmm. And after going abroad, mm-hmm. how I can build up my society, my nation? How?
Very good question, really. You provoke me really to speak out on this matter. Actually, nation and nationalism, I think your question is related to nation and nationalism. Actually, the very concept of nationalism, it goes beyond the national boundary. That is called transnationalism. You might have seen the people who are living in America, who are living in Europe, they are celebrating Dashain, they are celebrating Tej, they are celebrating different cultural festivals, fairs, better than in Nepal, really. When we leave our country, then we can show the belongingness, the love for our nation, that can be felt in our heart, and they can contribute in different way for their nation, no doubt. And the government of Nepal is also planning to provide an RN citizenship. They can invest, if they are earning something there, then they can invest here in Nepal, their mother country, no doubt. Mm. That's a good point. That's a good thing.
Most of the people mm-hmm. feel very good while going abroad. Mm-hmm. What's maybe the secret?
I didn't get a question properly, please.
Most of the people, mm-hmm. they feel happy yeah. while going abroad. Mm-hmm. What may be the secret reason?
Actually, the secret reason that is not secret. Actually, that is open secret.
Mm-hmm.
There is no proper management of human resources in Nepal. Even after doing master's degree, they are not getting the job of a lower class people, right?
Mm-hmm.
They are not getting labor class job also. So they are forced to leave their country, motherland, though they have loved their motherland, nation, of course, no doubt, but they are forced to leave their country. Let us suppose master degree holder, gold medalist of physics, that is the genuine manpower and that is needed for our country. But America is giving a scholarship for them and they are managing certain logistics for them and they are doing research for America. And America is collecting a benefit out of it, out of our resourceful manpower, intelligent manpower, intellectual manpower. So from the side of government of Nepal, they should think of those cream manpowers who can contribute for the nation. There is research center in Nepal. They can manage those cream manpowers who are toppers, gold medalists. They can contribute by doing research on the behalf of Nepal. But unfortunately, they are doing research on the behalf of USA. And USA is getting progress and it is becoming the superpower of the world. That is the hidden secret. Look at it. He's collecting manpower, almost cream manpowers around the globe. He's giving PR, green card, even in the name of filling of TVs. They're collecting manpowers.
Do you feel happy while going abroad, do you feel happy?
Very difficult question for me. Actually, I'm serving in my own motherland, and in my own country. There is no repentance, there is no thing to ponder over the issue, but actually, still in our country, there is no professionalism for kind information. Look at, I'm a teacher. I've been teaching in Samriddhi College, and I've been teaching in Sainika Avasiya Mahavidyalaya.
Mm-hmm.
But still, I cannot leave at least the average people of Nepal. What I mean to say is, we are not getting livelihood by being totally dedicated to our profession.
Mm-hmm.
The question is of bread and butter.
Mm-hmm.
So people are forced to leave their country. That is not their choice at all. They are forced. Even after being dedicated to my profession from early in the morning to the evening, I cannot make my life happy, then I should think through other options.
Mm-hmm.
That's the natural thing. So my wife is also engaged somewhere. She's a medical personnel. But whatever she's doing here, she's hardly getting 40,000-45,000 here.
Mm-hmm.
By giving full-time duty over there. Mm-hmm. In the hospital. But only by giving the same time to other European countries or USA, we can get better lifestyle, we can have better opportunities, they can send for research. So people are forced to leave their mother country. That is their obligation.
Mr. Sapkota, by going abroad, can we make our country properly? We like to go abroad. And how we can make our country and nation properly? Do you believe that?
Very good question. Making country, nation formation, that is a big issue. For making my country, there is no necessity, it is not mandatory to live here in my own country. Even after being in America, even after being in Australia, even after being in Canada, I can think of my nation, I can contribute a lot than that of being here in my country. Of course. So look at, you can think of C.S. Raleigh and different other NRNs who are investing here in Nepal. We can think of nation, even as I just told you before, nationalism, nation formation, process of building our nation, that is goal. That goes beyond national territory, national boundary. Actually, nationalism, the issue in itself is very difficult issue. And there is transnationalism. Look at, as I told you before, transnationalism is a big issue. When we leave our country, then the accumulated love, the belongingness to our country, it becomes intense. It becomes really intense.
Mr. Sapkota, what should be the social responsibility of a citizen?
Wow, very good question. First of all, government should think of its region. First of all, government should provide at least basic necessities should be fulfilled for its region. Look at, people are dying of starvation. You might have heard the Karnali and its predicament. People are dying of hunger. Look at, they are not getting suitable. Look at, people are dying of fever. How pathetic the situation is. First of all, government should think for its citizen. Then only citizen will pay back for the nation, for its social security. Look at, you might have heard about Australia and other, look at Europe, America, Canada. In those countries, there is good social security. But here in our country, you might have heard about one incident of Dr. Wagley, was very dedicated towards his nation. Look at, he was contributing in his own village, but he died of, cancer. But government could do nothing for him. Look at how pathetic the situation was, it still is. So, first of all, my point here is, first of all, government should set certain rule and regulation. Law and order should be maintained there in country. Then only citizen will pay back. It's a tax, we are paying tax. Look at, for riding back on the vehicle, we are paying back for the nation. It's a tax. But look at the poor condition of road.
Mr. Sapkota, you are working lecturer of Samriddhi College.
Yeah.
And as well as at Sainik College as well, which is located at Bhaktapur. And my question is, what should be a lecturer, teacher or professor social responsibility to make aware to their student and citizen, to your citizen, to your student?
Yeah, let us not say citizen. We are doing our duties on the behalf of a student. We are imparting knowledge to our students, and that is also part of nation building. As you just asked me before, that is a part of nation building. We are contributing for the nation building process, no doubt. We are imparting education to the students. The student will be doctor, engineer. Almost all the professions are produced by the teachers. So teaching is prestigious job, no doubt. But look at in Nepal, how pathetic the situation is of teachers.
Now, if so, how our Nepal, how a citizen make relief from this critical situation? Be relief from this critical situation.
First of all, government of Nepal should mend the policies to control, to restrict for going abroad. But I mean, not that living in democratic country, we should not restrict any people for going from going abroad.
Personally, I cannot say don't go abroad to anybody. Personally, yes. I cannot say.
Yeah.
This is not ethical.
Of course.
Yeah.
I mean, not that. Actually, my point was not that a government should restrict people or its region for going abroad. But if they provide opportunity for those cream team, intellectual personalities which are denouncing their nation, their country, their situation, their real condition of existence, and they're going to abroad by getting PR, green card and scholarships there. So why not to manage certain job opportunities why not to give certain research work to those intellectual persons who are the toppers, right? Especially, we might have observed that. We have seen the toppers of physics and other applied science students. Their only one dream is to go to abroad, to be a good professional in their field. So only by going abroad, we should not be worried. But they should get back to their nation to contribute, to serve. And government should also manage certain facilities, certain conducive working environment over here. That is my point.
Dear listener, you are listening Radio Janasanchar 107.9 MHz. At the moment, we have short break. After break, I will see you again. देशको शैक्षिक वातावरण, अध्ययन, अध्यापन, नीति निर्माण र शैक्षिक चेतना फैलाउने उद्देश्यले प्रसारित कार्यक्रम शैक्षिक छलफल. Welcome back again at Radio Jana Sansar 107.9 MHz at the program named Educational Discussion, and I am Ravin Basnet, Mr. Saab Kota, the working lecturer of Samriddhi as well as Sainik College. You are heartily welcome in this program again.
Thank you, sir.
People like to stay long time at abroad. And studying long time at abroad, more than 10 years, 15 years, and working more than 10 years, 15 years at abroad, is it beneficial to our nation or not? In your personal experience and opinion.
Very difficult question, hard to answer the question. Actually, you might have seen and heard about so many personalities that have got back ultimately after 20 years to Nepal, remaining there in abroad, being there in abroad. Yeah, no doubt, that is a great loss for the nation, right? They are spending their youth, their enthusiasm, their courage to the abroad, and after not being able to do something for the nation, they're getting back. In the name of dying in the motherland, they're getting back to Nepal. Look at that is the pathetic situation. They're making money, they're doing research for other countries, they're contributing for the economic activities of other countries and abroad, and ultimately, in the hope of dying in Nepal, they're getting back in Nepal. That is really sad and pathetic situation of our country. So again, no point. That is the big issue, and that should be thought twice by the policymakers. Government of Nepal should think over those issues. That is a big issue. Brain drain in itself is really very, very difficult to settle down, and we cannot restrict people from going abroad, but by managing them, by providing job opportunities, relevant work for those intellectual citizens, government should think twice for the problem of brain drain.
Mr. Saab Kota, going abroad and staying abroad a long time, what may be the losses? What should be the losses for us, for our nation?
I think I have already answered this question.
What are the things which we are going to lose by having those peoples, those citizens at abroad?
People could have done different research for the progress of our nation. Our economic activities would flourish. Our our educational activities and our economic activities would flourish. But instead of being engaged here in Nepal, we are converting Nepali currencies to dollar, American dollar, Australian dollar, Canadian dollar, and we are exporting not only human resources, we are exporting our Nepalese currencies, converting to American dollar and others, and we are losing human resources. As human resources is the backbone for the nation building process, we are not only losing human resources, we are also converting Nepali currencies to dollar. Now you might have heard about our national bank calling for dollar, buying dollar from other banks, other international banks. There is a scarcity of dollar. Look at. Why? Because there is a brain drain, and you might have got information that almost thousands of students are getting no objection letter to go for abroad study. All of them are collecting, all of them are converting Nepalese currencies to dollars and others, and they are moving, they are going away. That's a great loss for our nation, no doubt. And only in village there are disabled women and old age people. Look at, the youths are flying away. So my request to those who are moving away, flying away, at least think of Nepal, and think, how can you contribute for your nation, even being in abroad?
They say that they are giving money to Nepal by working over there. They are giving revenue. Can we develop our nation by having those kind of revenue from brain drain and other skillful personalities of our nation?
Very good question. As our nation is revenue-based economy, our country has become a revenue-based economy. Few years before, we would call it agro-based economy. But today, we have to call it very unfortunately, it is revenue-based economy, and which is very inconsistent. Inconsistent in a sense that how long we are sending our youths to the abroad, and especially as the labor class people, they are sending revenues for kind of information. Those students who are going for abroad study and their further study, who are getting a scholarship, they are dreaming to settle down there by getting PR, green cards and others. They are not getting back to Nepal and they are not sending revenue, sir. Actually, as far as I know, those students who are moving to abroad for their further study, they are converting Nepalese currencies to dollar. And they are these are the problems of our national economy. They're not sending revenues. And in itself, revenue-based, remittance-based economy, that is the blunder.
Blunder, mistake.
Yeah. That's the very great mistake of our country. Why? Because there is no consistency at all. There is no consistency. Being remittance-based economy, that's the same for our nation.
Mr. Sadhguta, we are receiving a lot of revenue nowadays. We have a lot of money from the revenue sector.
Why? I think you are indicating remittance, not revenue actually.
Remittance, all right, okay. Remittance, revenue. Okay, by having those kind of remittance or revenue, why it is hard or why it is difficult to develop our country? Although that is money.
You might have heard different socio-cultural impact of remittance economy. Young guy of 25, he gets married. And recently after getting married, after a few days or after a few months, he goes for abroad to sell his liver. Look at, I think you might have guessed my indication or what I have been indicating. Recently, after getting married, after a few days, few months, he's going back to abroad to sell his labor. Look at how can you think of his family? How can you think of good education his children are getting there? So revenue remittance-based economy in itself is very, very difficult, and it is not sustainable. For sustainable economy, remittance is a problem. Why not to make our youths get engaged here in our own country? Why don't we give good opportunities to work over here? They are very pathetic situation. We are receiving our thousands of youths are going abroad to sell their labor, and every day in the coffin we are receiving dead bodies. Look at that is the another tragic situation. But it's very, very pathetic. That is the same for our country. We were known as Bir Gurkhas, ancestor of Bir Gurkhas, but now our identity has become very in liminal space. Look at that is the same for our country, I think.
Mr. Sadhguta, between human resources and the money, between human resources and money, which you choose must for developing our nation, which will be the best, which will be the appropriate one?
Very good question.
Or both one?
Difficult. Both are important. Actually, we have heard there is the 83,000 megawatt of hydroelectricity potential we have, but due to the lack of human resources, due to the lack of technology, and due to the lack of money, we are not being able to excavate, we are not being able to utilize those hydropower of 83,000 megawatt. I think I did answer to your question. Are equally important. At first, human manpower is the most important. Why? Because if we have qualified, dexterous human manpower, human resources, we can liberate, we can generate money out of it, we can have better innovations, innovations of scientific technologies and discoveries. until and unless we have qualified, dexterous human resources, we cannot think of developing our nation. So the prime concern is dexterous human resources, no doubt.
It means you answered human resources is a most important thing than money,
of course.
Comparatively.
Yes.
If so, personally, I cannot say don't go abroad. I cannot stop them for not going abroad. I don't can say. Mm-hmm. I don't.
Yeah.
And I don't say never.
Of course.
But our government can say. But also our government is not saying to them not go or do not go abroad. They usually has given the no objection letter to them.
Yeah.
What may be the secret reason why they don't like to stop our youth, our capable, our intellectual, our smart, energetic person? Why they don't stop? There are a lot of reasons. Please give me some.
Very good question, Ravinji. Actually, we are living in the 21st era, no doubt. Don't forget that. And people are talking about global village, and we are living in democratic world. So government cannot restrict the people from going abroad for their higher study and by getting PR or green card and others. But government, what can government do is they can have better management here. They can create job opportunities. There are so many hydropowers being initiated nowadays, and the engineers are going to sell their labor to Gulf countries and other countries. So government can manage it. Government can attract the intellectual people, their youths. They can provide job for them, but they cannot restrict, but they cannot stop the flow of going abroad. On the one hand, the deprive of opportunities, they are deprived of bread and butter, and on the other hand, if the government starts saying you can't go to abroad, then that is the dictatorship. In democratic country, we cannot say so. We can't restrict our citizen from going abroad for their further study or any other purpose.
Mr. Sapkota, if you have basic needs, for example, buildings, job security, car, mobile phone, and each and every things, and each and every facility which we need. At that time also, do you like to feel happy to go abroad? Money, car, building, each and everything if you have.
Very
do you feel
philosophical question. I think this is very philosophical question, and you know it very well that our degree of satisfaction, it can never be quenched. So it's a kind of climbing on the mountains. As long as we climb up the mountains, we see the broader horizon. The horizon becomes broader. Few years before, I didn't have mobile. 10 years before, I didn't have mobile. At first, I had Nokia. And now, I have Note series of Samsung. So, this is all about degree of satisfaction. And the same instinct of human beings is we are not being satisfied with our present condition, present situation, real condition of existence. That very sense of dissatisfaction, we are doing progress. The word that is progress, what we are aspiring for. The sense of dissatisfaction, it leads towards the progress, human progress. If we go through the evolution of human civilization on Earth, we are slowly and gradually, we are evolving, the evolution of human civilization, it goes like that. If we could have satisfied with the agricultural era, we could not have arrived here in the era governed by science and technology. We are living in coca culture. We are living in multinational companies era. America is no more nation. Look at, people used to call it melting pot. Now it is salad bowl. Look at, black, white, wheat, white. Almost all the people that found there in USA. We cannot say, we cannot find out who is real American, who is native. If we talk about Native American, they are still living in jungle. America is like a salad bowl, and it's a kind of multinational company. America is no more than that of multinational company. There is a high investment of China in USA. Mm-hmm. So America does not want to collapse Chinese economy. Now look at you. You might have heard about China's economy. That is the greatest economy of the world. Since 2-3 years, mm-hmm. now China has surpassed America's economy. USA's economy, look at. So the same instinct, dissatisfaction that is leading us towards our what we call progress.
Dear listener, you are listening Radio Janasanchar 107.9 MHz. At the moment, you have short break. After break, I will see you again. देशको शैक्षिक वातावरण अध्ययन अध्यापन नीति निर्माण र शैक्षिक चेतना फैलाउने उद्देश्यले प्रसारित कार्यक्रम शैक्षिक छलफल Welcome back again at the Radio Janasanchar 107.9 MHz at the program named Educational Discussion. I am Ravim Basnet and I am with educational personality. His name is Rajesh Sapkota. He is a working lecturer of Samriddhi College as well as Sainik College, Swaktapur. You are welcome back again.
Thank you, Ravinji.
Mr. Sapkota, why do our government cannot make stop our citizen in Nepal?
Thank you, Ravinji. That's a difficult question to answer. Why? Because government has its own limitations, could not have maintained political stability. Almost 1 year is already passed away. We gave the constitution to the people, but still people are fighting there. There is no common consensus made there. And due to the lack of law and order, stable policy, people are not getting conducive environment over here to invest. Those in RN also, they are not feeling comfortable to invest here in Nepal. All the hydroelectricities, the people, the government of Nepal could attract investment, and people could be straight here, those intellectual manpowers and youths who are dreaming of flying away, flying to abroad for their better career, better opportunities. I think due to the lack of political stability, lack of law and order, stable policy, there is a massive flight of youths in abroad.
Mr. Sapkota, don't you feel that by having our youth energetic and intellectual and educated person and smart energetic person having it abroad, we are facing some problems socially, economically? Don't you feel that?
Whether they are feeling your question, I think you are intending to answer the question of liminal space.
I like to repeat again.
Okay.
We have our mother, father, they are matured, mm-hmm. they are aged,
yeah.
and their youth, mm-hmm. their young son, daughter, now at abroad. Mm-hmm. And how they are feeling? Mm. Socially, at that I am going to ask you the question.
Very good question, Ravinji. We are in the 21st century, and our country, our socio-cultural values are dismantling in the sense that the youths are flying away, flying abroad, there is a brain drain, and only old generation, the people from old generation are staying back here in Nepal, and they are more or less, in a sense, they are not being able to give continuity to our customs, tradition, and the youths who are living in abroad, they are also lamenting for their deeds. They could have, they think they could have stayed here in Nepal, but again, they are forced to go there. In my opinion, especially as far as I have acknowledged the problems of youth as being a youth, myself, that's their problem. That's the obligation, big problem of Nepal. Especially, what sort of manpower we have, if we analyze the human resources critically, analytically, then it's our great pleasure that we have working class people more than 50% Means it's our pleasure. 50 to 56% is working class people. Means young people, energetic people. In population pyramid, if we talk critically, analytically, then we have working class people, booming working class people. Our population pyramid is a kind of convex lens, means booming youths. That's our pleasure. That is good point. But again, unfortunately, we are not being able to manage this population. The GOC in Nepal. First of all, government should make a stable policy. There should be political stability here. And law and order should be maintained here. Conducive environment. Conducive investment environment should be created here for the entrepreneurship.
Mr. Rajesh Sapkota, lecturer of Samriddhi as well as Sainik College, Bhaktapur. I'd like to ask you an imaginary question. If you at abroad, for example, how much those you're having at abroad, how much it will be beneficial, how much you can take advantage from abroad, personally, if you at abroad? Imaginary question.
Good question, Ravinji. That is hypothetical, imaginary, but I could have done research, I could have collected certain amount of money for the betterment of my nation. I would get back to my nation after doing some research, after completing my PhD. I could have get back to my country, and whatever I could have earned over there, I would get back to Nepal and invest here in academic sector.
Personally, is it beneficial for a specific person for going abroad?
That's a difficult question to answer. Each and every individual are distinct, and perspective depends. People have different perspective to look towards the idea, right? Whether it is beneficial for them or not, they should decide by themselves. Whether it is beneficial for me or not, that is myself is responsible for my career. So whether that is beneficial for others to get to go to abroad, that is better. Better to get some skill, some knowledge. It is better to get some educational degrees from abroad, and they could have learned, they could get information. What's the difference between Nepalese education system and abroad? What sort of evaluation systems are there? We are facing really monotonous, hackneyed, traditional way of education over here. They could get lots of information. That's why going abroad in itself is not wrong. I don't see anything wrong there. Going abroad for further study, by getting a scholarship there. But while choosing the research, they could have chosen the research article for the benefit and the behalf of our country. Why don't they do research on the potentialities and challenges on the behalf of excavating hydroelectricity, especially in the countries like ours, where there is geographical difficulties? What are the pros and cons of excavating hydroelectricity over here? But they are doing research on the behalf of other countries.
Mr. Sapkota, if you are at abroad, after some time, do you feel comfortable to back Nepal?
First of all, once again, I would like to tell you very frankly, I'm not intending to go to abroad. I'm here satisfied doing my duties over here, contributing my nation and contributing something. A small break in the process of nation formation. I'm serving my nation, and why are you forcing me to go abroad, Pravinji?
I'm not forcing.
So that is very hypothetical question to answer. Yeah, I have been serving for my nation, and I'm contributing a small break in the process of nation formation. And both of us, me and my wife, we are doing something here. And my nation, in our nation, we are contributing something. So I'm very happy. I'm not, I have never even imagined of going abroad. I'm happy here.
Happy in Nepal?
Yeah, in Nepal, I'm happy. I'm satisfied.
Mr. Sapkota, do you know, I'd like to say one more question to you. Is there any legal provision for going abroad?
Legal provision for going abroad First of all, an immigrant or a student should get university's letter. His application should be approved from there, from those university, wherever they are willing to go for their further study. And they should get no objection letter from Ministry of Education or from the side of government of Nepal. And they're getting it, and they are paying certain money to the foreign universities, abroad universities, and they are converting Nepalese currencies to dollar, and they're paying, and they're doing their educational degrees in abroad. I think that's all. Okay. At least they should get no objection letter from government of Nepal.
Okay, Sapkota, we have a limited time now, and I'd like to ask you a final question. Okay. As a Nepali citizen, how we can reform our Nepal in best way, finally?
Very big question, Pravinji. Really? I think it's better to ask to the politician. if they are in policy makers.
Being a student, we have also some social responsibility. That's why I asked this question to you.
As you told just before, and as I responded to you, each and every citizen, each and every member of the society, if they start doing their duty sincerely, their job sincerely, then automatically each and every individual, if they are combined, society becomes, right? Society is the combination of each and every individual and family, and all the families, they make society. And if we start taking positive initiation from nation building, if I do my job sincerely, if I start doing my job sincerely, and accordingly, if you start doing your job sincerely, Ravinji, then of course, automatically, if all the citizens of Nepal, they start thinking positively, then no doubt, Nepal will be prosperous. Okay. But we should have pure from our inner heart.
Okay, Mr. Sapkota, finally, what you like to say to your teacher, your friends, your guardians, and the person who are directly connected or related to education, finally?
Yeah, very good question.
In conclusion.
For the people, those who are academician and they are contributing for the nation building process, don't take educational sector as a business. It's not a business. It's not money making job. Please try to think that you are dedicated to contribute something for the nation, for nation building process, and be pure from your heart. And for those students who are willing to go for their further study in abroad, please get back to your motherland. Contribute something for your motherland. Get knowledge, skill, technologies from abroad, from other countries, and explore yourself in the soil of your own motherland, for your own country, do something.
Thank you very much for your involvement and participant and best speaking in this popular radio program, 107.9 MHz.
Thank you, Ravinji. Many thanks. It's my pleasure, as you called me for the program, as you thought me as a suitable personality to talk something, to disseminate my ideas on the behalf of my students and my colleagues and the people who are engaged in educational sector. Thank you for providing me the opportunity to express my opinions, my ideas.
Dear respected listener, he was Mr. Rajesh Sapkota and is working lecturer of English language and literature at Saini College, Sallaghari, Bhaktapur, as well as Samriddhi College, Lokanthali, Bhaktapur. Thank you very much for listening this program. See you next week with another educational and academic personality. Bye for now.